Today, I want to take this opportunity to extend my appreciation, admiration, and gratitude to those of you out there that might have took this opportunity to listen to what I identified as Navajo philosophy of learning. My name is Wilson Aronilth Jr. I have a clan too that identifies me as a Navajo. I'm originally from a place called Cliff Rose Creek, New Mexico. That's where I was born and raised. I was raised by my grandmother. She educated me and taught me all these Navajo philosophy of learning. So she's my resource and my reference. And she always told me these Navajo philosophy of learning was created and designed by the holy people and divine nature. And it was given to our great forefathers, our grandmothers and grandfathers, our people to live by. It regulated and constituted their generation's blood flow to understand where we are coming from, who created us, why we are here today, and the direction we can go another 1,000 years. That's the interpretation of our Navajo philosophy. That's what my grandmother said. So it's important to learn it, although it's not written black and white. So for myself, I learned it through oral lecture. I didn't read a book or did a research. It's something that I learned following my grandmother. She said, in the learning of our Navajo philosophy, we have to learn to understand our Navajo feeling, thoughts, and thinking first. That discipline is important before we can go into learning about the values, believing the teaching of our Navajo philosophy. If we don't, she said, you might confuse yourself. We were told that there's a philosophy of patience. We have to learn to be patient, to learn the outline of our understanding of our feeling, thought, and thinking, to understand the teaching of Navajo philosophy. As a person, we have to undertake to teach ourselves specifically how to apply the laws of our Navajo mind to understand our ideas and reasons of thinking. This is how we have success of life and a healthy education in our life. As a Navajo, we are told that we must understand that the teaching of our Navajo philosophy is not to be regarded as something evil, bad, negative, fairy tale, and false. Because sometimes if we do that, we confuse ourselves and have a lot of negative questions about our belief and values. So she said, don't do that. Don't try to add or delete one of the most important concepts of your philosophy. Keep it natural, the way it was taught to you, the way that it was told to you. Follow that system, she said. Because the teaching of our Navajo philosophy is a natural laws of the divine holy people and divine nature. These laws of philosophy, this teaching works all the time, every minute of our life, every breath we take, it's in working process, which we call That's how we say it. We are told that nothing or nobody on the face of the earth is big enough to stop it from working. Some did in their way, and look, today there is a lot of problem of life today, confusion. Many, many questions of our young people. They say that every human, based on different color of the skin, were given their own philosophy of knowledge and wisdom, their natural law to follow. And we're one of those human beings. We have our own given philosophy. It's a living philosophy. It works all the time. So be careful as you use your philosophy. Be honest and be truthful. Have love. Accept other philosophy. Don't be negative about other people's philosophy. Respect them. That's the philosophy of learning that I want to share with you. Now I'm going to go to the first topic. I call it the Navajo philosophy of knowledge and wisdom that explains our intelligence. Number one, according to the teaching of our great forefathers, grandmothers and grandfathers, our philosophy can explain our Navajo intelligence. Why? A, because our Navajo philosophy is a living philosophy that comes from the divine holy people and divine nature. B, because it is endeavor to obtain a sharp consistency of understanding of our Navajo feeling, thought, thinking, and how we observe things, creation. This develops a guideline for us to see and understand ourselves and the beautiful creation that is before us. C, because the intelligence of our Navajo philosophy is an attempt to think things through. And that the understanding of self-love comes from our feeling and thought. D, because the characteristic attitude of our Navajo philosophy is to be patient, to listen, to be obedient, have an open mind, serious discipline of honesty, and ambitious efforts to find the truth principle of the truth principle of the traits of reality as in character. You have to understand your characteristic. That's number one. Number two, because we have to find the true principle of the significant meaning of human existence. Three, we have to find our place in the universe as a whole. Four, why we are the way we are and that we are different from other people. We're all unique and beautiful, intelligent people. Now we're on number two. We are told that our Navajo philosophy is a reasoned effort to see facts, ideas, emotion and its truth. With this understanding, we as Navajo will realize that the universe is sacred in such a way that they all go together to make more sense. In other words, in a truthful way, we all go together with the universe, the divine creation, in a way that will make more sense to our life. And when we do this, this will mean we are following the natural order of life. Number three, Navajo philosophy of intelligence is attempt to grasp in our thoughts and the forms of existence disclosed to in human existence, the search by thought for the rational structure of existence, some people call it. That's how you learn the purpose in life. Number four, the new philosophy is the knowledge of existence. Navajo philosophy is the knowledge of existence to search for the existence of humanities and the holy people and divine nature, how it takes process to work together, and we are in the hands of these creation. We're their children. That's how it was told. Number five, our great forefathers, grandmothers and grandfathers said that our Navajo philosophy is based upon holiness. This is to say, Navajo philosophy seeks to understand the value of the truth principle of life, not only in terms of relationship to other things of life. For example, the significance of a man's physical makeup and a woman's physical makeup can be understood only as we see it in its relationship with other aspects of male and female nature. But if we know that a male and female creation was created at a special place called Hayaskaspehuan by the divine holy people, then we will understand a deeper physical makeup. Just like they say in philosophy, you should never look at a woman all naked and a man all naked in other creation. If there's respect, there's a truth principle to it. You respect that. That was our understanding once one time. Number six, the significance of Diné existence can be understood by where they were first created. Like, do we know where we were created? Where are we coming from? If you understand that, then by considering Navajo relationship to other living things in your environment, in this creation, the world we live in, then it has a lot of understanding why it is that way. A belief in our feelings and thoughts will show the meaning of human life. Like, for example, for the question of the meaning of something in human life that we know to know is honest and beautiful. For the question of the meaning of something is the question of its place in the holiness to which it belongs. You know, why are you here today? What are you doing? Where are you going? That one, so it's important. Number seven, the new philosophy of intelligence means gifted Navajos are born and made. We are told that we are potentially gifted individuals to do good. As a Diné, as a Navajo, you can truly, you know, determine that you are gifted by performance. What you do when you use your talent, ability properly. Navajo philosophy of intelligence can explain your talent, your ability in a beautiful way. You don't really have to go to a book or do research. It's already in your life, but it's how you internalize it and use it to understand it. Navajo philosophy of intelligence is the ability to understand the interrelationship of the presented facts in such a way as to guide our action towards a desired goals of life. something we need in our wants in life. And then understanding the power of meeting, to meet any situation, to use our ability to succeed in meeting and solving problems of life, to be healed, to be more organized. This is the way that we were told. Number 9, the new philosophy of intelligence is the capacity for understanding truth facts, and then its meaning, its interpretation. Also, to improve our understanding of true facts and the meaning of those true facts, where we don't have to question or be confused. We'll understand it in order that it goes. Novel philosophy of intelligence is the ability that we as individuals possess for meeting new situation and even problems of life with the right mental attitude and so forth, and the ability to understand and see into our problems, if we do have problems, into our work, our education, and our situation that we're in, to apply what we have learned through the experience of our own Navajo philosophy. And when we learn and experience our own philosophy, that's where we heal, and that's where we find joy and happiness. This is the way that we were told. Not all philosophy of intelligence is not a thing of which we have more or less, but we are born with it. The day we conceive inside our mother's womb, our novel philosophy intelligence was already there within our growth and development. For this reason, it is a way of acting, a way of life. It gives us a certain special spiritual attitude, social attitude, common attitude, and physical attitude. It gives us a special spiritual behavior, social behavior, common behavior, physical behavior. Then it gives us a special a spiritual personality, a social personality, a common personality, and then a common characteristic in our life to understand we are Navajo, we are Nahuka Diné. Number 12, we as Navajo will show our philosophy of intelligence when we handle a situation intelligently. Intelligence depends upon the knowledge rather than merely having it. We have to internalize it, use it, put it into action, not just talk about it. They say put it into action. Sometimes we say a person knows a lot, but yet it is rather not right, because that person makes a little use of what they know relating to the intelligence of the philosophy. They don't really try to blend it and internalize into their life to survive, to have good health and good sound mind, to have prosperity and to have joy and happiness in their life. Sometimes that's how you see people struggle. Now, based upon our Navajo intelligence, today we don't want to struggle as Navajo people, especially our Navajo youth. Those are some of the things that I want to share with you. Based upon that, it's good to say that, think about your Navajo capabilities to achieve something good in your life that relates to the intelligency of your Navajo philosophy. And you all have your good philosophy. Look into it and begin to understand and live by it. That's what we were told. So what I'm trying to say at this time to complete my talk is, think about your limitation and capabilities and the level of achievement that are open for you, that is there for you. Take advantage of your opportunity in a good way. Now, remember to examine your purpose in your life, your goals and objectives, to see if they are really attainable. Then you won't make any mistake later on. You're going to have a good, solid foundation. Based upon what I mean by that is, you're going to have a nice home, a nice family in life. That's important. Also, try to see what really lies in your future and clarify your Navajo self-identity and get to know who you really are, your purpose in this world. Just like your language, your Navajo language is very important, because they say your Navajo language is your vision, your mission, your philosophy, your objectives and goals. It identifies you. And I used to hear my grandma say this, and some other elders, the color of your skin as a Navajo doesn't exactly make you unique. Your Navajo language makes you unique. That's your identification. Don't ever forget your language. That's what we were told. And based upon that, they say, learn to clarify your purpose in life to be successful. Commit yourself to your endeavors of life. Don't be playing around, because you might hurt yourself. That's what we were told. Learn to understand and recognize your moods, your feeling, your thought, your thinking. Look at your attitude, your behavior, your personality, your characteristics, and your mind to be more positive of yourself, to find the meaning of life in the world that you are living, or in the world that we are living. The meaning of life is beautiful if you want it to be beautiful. And you have the knowledge, the wisdom, the opportunity to learn that. And these are some of the few things that I wanted to share with you. And these knowledge is really coming from the Institute for Diné Culture, Philosophy and Government, that we've designed it to help our people, Navajo people, and whoever has the interest to learn these disciplines and stories. So it was a good opportunity to share some of these few knowledge with you, and hopefully we could continue on communicating like this as we go along. Thank you for this opportunity.